I had all those kinds of panicking thoughts going through my head. As a matter of fact, when I actually confronted Jezebel for what it was, I literally thought that I was going to faint because my heart was beating out of my chest and I felt like I was starting to lose consciousness. It was like I was having a panic attack. I'm a little Josiah. I'm the little Josiah that could. And that's what I was the other day when I overcame the spirit of Jezebel. Jezebel tends to be a woman. I've known many women with the spirit of Jezebel. I've known one person that was a man that maybe had the spirit of Jezebel. This isn't like a sexist thing. This is just how it is typically. And I've also been seeking my identity as a man of God. I've been seeking manhood a lot recently. So a lot of this plays into key, especially in my personal situation that I'll talk briefly about, but I'm not going to get into too many details because it is personal. But I do want to talk about how I overcame Jezebel. It's very important because so many people do struggle with this. So anyways, regardless of like genderism or whatever, you know, it's not necessarily about that. It can be, and a lot of times it is, but not all of the time. So anyways, let's just start off by saying that there is actually nothing in the Bible that precisely expresses Jezebel to be a demon, hands down. There's nothing that actually says that. It's kind of, I could see how it's hinted at, like for example in Revelation when Jesus is talking about that woman Jezebel that you allow in the church. This was obviously not talking about the queen Jezebel that married Ahab in the Old Testament because she's been dead for a long time. But what it is talking about is someone who is comparable to that queen Jezebel and is using whatever she can in her own self-claimed power to bring the church down using sin, idol worship, sexual immorality, and who knows what. So I'm not actually here to argue about how Jezebel is a spirit or Jezebel is just a character trait. I'm not here to talk about that. Most people identify Jezebel as a demonic spirit, and so therefore I'm actually just going to talk about Jezebel as a spirit. There's a debate online with Christians and also kind of in not Christians about whether Jezebel and narcissist are the same thing. And I don't really know. I don't even know how to dissect that debate. Like I said, there's like not much theology on any of this, but you know, regardless, there is someone who is in a false state of authority, and that within itself is biblical. And that person oftentimes carries very similar traits as Jezebel, so I don't have a problem identifying as Jezebel. So yeah, the biggest thing is that Jezebel tends to try and step into an authority that she doesn't actually have. It's her own authority, and it's not the will of God. And what Jezebel does in the church is she tries to destroy the church, however she can. People always talk about sexual immorality, and I've noticed that Jezebel's never tempted me sexually. Then again, I don't get that tempted physically, sexually, and I've been very celibate, so I guess that's just kind of out of the topic for me specifically. But what I can say is that Jezebel can only get certain people and relatively very few people to actually be seduced by her, to be manipulated. What Jezebel does to everyone, though, is try to control them by degrading them, manipulating them through fear, and just downranking their reputation. You know, so Jezebel recently, like, as I've been seeking specifically manhood, this is my personal testimony, right? I've been seeking my authority and sticking up for what's right, because that's what a man of God does. So I've been learning how to stick up for what's right in gentleness and in love. And, you know, I think you guys know me that I'm not some crazy, like, that I'm not some crazy, aggressive, you know, violent person. I've never been in a fist fight in my life or anything like that. You know, but one of the things that I've seen about me being a peacemaker is that a lot of times I've just submitted to fear. And with submitting to fear, a lot of people have an advantage over me. And so I've just been cutting that out of my freaking life like no other. And so the other day I'm talking to this woman and she's really nice and seems very helpless and very, very kind and helping. But at the end of the day, she's just trying to control me. She's criticizing me. She's telling me all about, she's belittling me and hurting my man pride. Like she really was. And you know, it was really humiliating. And honestly, it made me curl up and submit to fear. And so this is wrong. Just for my own thing, I knew this was wrong, but I didn't know how to get over it because there was so much fear and intimidation going on. And so that's the biggest tactic with Jezebel. Jezebel uses fear no matter what. I swear, it's always about fear. It's always about what harm could happen to you. What reputation can she give you that would negatively portray you? And after I was being controlled and it just felt like my whole reputation was in the fingers of this person, I realized that I had to really stick up for myself no matter what, even if it would have hurt their feelings. And so finally I just put my foot down and just basically told her without specifically saying I'm not going to deal with it, but that was clearly the message I stated, and it was well received, not because she received it well, but because it was positively, correctly, what's that word? Received. that word. You know, there's like this debate that I saw on the internet about like whether Jezebel and narcissists are the same thing. I really don't know. I'm pretty sure that every Jezebel I've ever met was a narcissist. So, you know, a lot of what you do is the same thing. You know how there's people online that like cast out demons and stuff, and then like this demon like manifests in them, and then what's your name? Jezebel. You know, and all of a sudden they're telling this demon called Jezebel to get out in the name of Jesus. Like, I've never experienced that ever. I never have. If it happens, I won't be surprised, honestly. Jezebel doesn't really manifest like that, as far as I know. Like, I've never personally seen that. Like I said, I wouldn't be surprised, but, you know, a lot of people talk about the way, like, you overcome Jezebel is just being blunt and just putting your foot down and saying, no, this doesn't belong here, and this belongs right here, and you're wrong, and get over it. And it's not about being it's not about being unloving, but at the end of the day, a lot of times people say that it typically ends up in a shouting match, and the person who is Jezebel, which is typically a woman, and usually it's a man confronting Jezebel, usually the person will try and pull the victim card, or he scared me, or I thought I was going to get hit. And at the end of the day, no matter what I notice is that when you confront Jezebel, a lot of times you will feel guilty for doing what's right. And this is what I felt in my personal experiences with Jezebel, especially after I won. I had to really put my foot down and say, look, I'm not wrong, I'm not crazy, and I did what's right. And, you know, no matter what the consequence may be, because there's all that fear going on about, oh no, I just did this, what if this person tries to wrong me somehow, what if this person gets other people involved and they take their side, because who knows what. You know, I had all those kinds of panicking thoughts going through my head. As a matter of fact, when I actually confronted Jezebel for what it was, I didn't physically say it, but when I put my foot down and said enough, I literally thought that I was going to faint, because my heart was beating out of my chest and I felt like I was starting to lose consciousness. It was like I was having a panic attack, and I was literally standing there, but I held my foot down and I made it through, and I knew I was right. This may seem hilarious, but honestly, I know a lot of men that struggle with the same kind of fear. I know a lot of people that struggle with the same kind of fear. I'm just speaking specifically to men, because men are typically oppressed by Jezebel more than other women are even. Women have a competition, but men have fear. Men just submit out of fear, and it's manipulative. Vanilla, plain, clear. That's the end of the story. Rather, women actually know how to not deal with it a little more. And I've noticed that. That's not always true. That's just one analogy, and it's just a broad statement. But that's not the point. I'm talking about my personal testimony, and I'm just talking about a lot of people that I've seen in the past deal with these kinds of things. I'm going to talk about one more thing in my experience that I found very crazy, is that after everything I went through, this person that was trying to oppress me and control me and use fear to manipulate me and downgrade me and, you know, beat down my reputation and all that, after I confronted this and said what I really believed, and I knew it was wrong what she was doing to me, and I just put my foot down and said I'm not going to deal with it, the next time she saw me, she actually gave me a gift to reconcile with me. And I was just kind of like, okay, cool. But what was funny about this is that Jezebel now got put in her place, and I really made it clear that I'm not going to deal with this, and this authority is going to die right now. And once I did that, I was in the proper authority, and so was that other person that had no authority over me or the entirety of the situation. It is actually right authoritative alignment. Let me just compare it to you like this. It's like a little teddy bear trying to sit on a king's throne, and this king is literally too scared to hurt this teddy bear's feelings and to make it get off the throne. You have to not submit to fear through the manipulation of Jezebel. It is not good. It is stealing your life. What I found out is that after I confronted Jezebel and put her in her place, I realized how much that I actually loved this particular individual in a way that I never knew that I loved this person. I loved her the way Jesus did, and I loved her because I believed in her and I had hope for her, but I also had hope for myself, and I knew that some things need to be shook up a little bit. And I know I personally have always dealt with struggling to understand tough love and receive it as love, but this situation has helped me so much. And more than anything else, what I learned about tough love is that tough love may be a little stern, it may be a little hard, it may hurt your feelings a little bit, but at the end, tough love is secure. And that's what's so rich and so great about tough love, is that it really is solid. It is secure, guys. When it's really done in the spirit of Jesus Christ, and when God speaks, he is patient and slow to anger, but he does have tough love. He is straightforward with us, and it's because he knows what's right for us, he knows what's best for us, and he loves us so much that he doesn't want us to get hurt. I'm sure many of you know that when you take that initial step of faith, when you jump off that cliff, you realize you're not falling, but you're
actually flying.
And Jezebel is just one simple thing to get rid of logically, but emotionally really difficult. And breaking through that can lead you to flying. Overcoming Jezebel will help you become the character you're actually made to be in Jesus Christ, and that's exactly what Satan doesn't want you to know, is your real identity. Your real identity is beautiful, it is confident, it is glorifying for God, and what strengthens it is the joy of the Lord. That is all I have to say today, but Jezebel is a really serious topic, and not a lot of people talk about it, and especially a lot of people don't talk about overcoming it, and it's probably because barely anyone is actually overcoming it in any way, shape, or form. And even though this may have been a little thing for me, I know it was a huge step for me, and I hope that this can help someone face their fears and really deal with these problems that they have in regards to this situation. And so with that being said, I can honestly and confidently say to everyone in this video that I love you all. And I am so happy that God is doing a great work in each and every one of us. But I just want to encourage you guys, if I was able to overcome this, then you definitely can. But that's all I have to say. I'm Josiah, and goodbye, guys.